Welcome to KratosBI. I'm Les Grossman, and I'm gonna show you. Oh, Sansa. Can you see me? Can you see me now? Am I on camera? Am I on? All right, I'm gonna show you how to make your Power BI reports not look like frickin' garbage. All right, let's get into it. So you wanna learn Power BI, huh? How about this? You take two steps back, you hit the subscribe button, you turn on the alarm bell, and you follow for all of the future content, all right? We'll see you later. Bye. Yeah, all right. So your Power BI reports look like trash, all right? I know it, I've seen them. They look like garbage. We're gonna fix that, and we're gonna fix it for good, all right? Let's head over to my desktop. I'm gonna show you how to do it. I'm gonna show you how to do it right. Okay, so here's your garbage Power BI report, all right? It's up, it looks like crap. It's black and white, it's the default themes, you know? It looks like any old rookie who just walked in off the street, dropped a couple things on a pallet and called it a day. That's garbage, we're stopping that, all right? So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure that we get it looking good from our from within the Power BI desktop. So first thing I want you to do is select the canvas, then I want you to head over to this format section right here, right? Frickin here, all right? So we're gonna click on the format and we're gonna open our canvas area. The canvas area, for people who can't see, it's this, okay? We're gonna select our background color and we want it to be a nice light gray, all right? If you can see whites on any of your visuals, like you have a background that's set, because that's like a default setting in a lot of places, I want you to select a visual. Right, select it, and I want you to go back to the format pane and go under general and effects, right up here, all right? This is where you turn the backgrounds off, all right? No backgrounds for this, all right? Now we're gonna go in and we're gonna turn the backgrounds off, and then if we have it on all of our visuals, all we're gonna do is we're gonna go up to the home tab and we're gonna make heavy use of this format painter here, right here, to keep it all formatted, okay? So we're gonna start, we're gonna make the selection, and then we're gonna apply the formatting to each of the visuals that we have. I already have it done, so I'm not wasting any more time, okay? Now I've got this together. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up PowerPoint, okay? PowerPoint I'm gonna use to create an image for my background. All right, here we can start to insert some shapes. We can copy it, we can paste it. We can start to lay out what we want our background to look like, okay? Now, I don't want this to look like garbage. I want this to look good, so I'm gonna use my enterprise themed colors, and I'm gonna use my enterprise logos, and I'm gonna make some frickin' sense out of it, all right? So I've already taken the time to do that. I've created all of my materials that I wanna have, so I've got a nice spot here for a title. I've got my logo down here in the lower corner so you guys can see this stuff, right? It's all added in. I even added in a little gradient here because gradients make things look a little nicer, okay? Now, I've got everything set up. Notice I don't have anything on the background because I want to leverage my background on my Power BI report, okay? So I'm gonna hit all, select A, Control A, Control A, you sonsas. All right, and I'm gonna hit right click. I'm gonna do save as picture, okay? Save as picture. You want to make sure you do this so it's easy for you to add in. Because I don't have a background on this, I'm gonna create a transparent area for me to work in, all right? So I'm gonna right click, save as picture, and I'm gonna save this out into my background folder where I've got all my stuff available, right? So boom, save, there it is, all right? Now, next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into Power BI, back to Power BI. I'm gonna go back to my canvas background, and I'm going to go to browse, and I want to add a file, all right? So right here, browse, add a file, browse. Oh, you sons of backgrounds. The one I created, hit enter. Now, it's important you choose fit. If you choose fit, boom, you're all good to go, all right? Now, I've got it in place. Hey, this looks great. I like this a lot, all right? So next thing I wanna do is I want to transform this into the theme that I really like, okay? So first things first, I wanna go to my background, my color, and I wanna hit more colors, and I wanna grab this frickin' color right here, all right? This is the color I want to use. Now, I go to view and themes, all right? Up in the corner here, and I go to customize the current theme, all right? It's right here, customize current theme. And I wanna go in and I wanna make sure that all this stuff gets set up right. So I'm gonna snap it. And I've got my current themes all add in. These are all my corporate colors. I gave it a name. Now I want to head into the page and I want to give this, I want this to be the specific color I just copied and pasted from before, okay? Okay, all right. So I hit apply, boom, I'm all done. But lest you say, what the heck? There's no background image there. Oh yeah, I know, I'm not dumb, all right? I know, I'm not dumb. I'm gonna add that in. First thing I'm gonna do though, is I'm gonna go and I'm gonna save my current theme. That's right up here. Save current theme, all right? I'm gonna hit on it. I'm gonna save this guy out. I'm gonna save it out as KratosBI right here, so you can see it. Hit save. Now, when I open this up, so this is the theme, what the theme is gonna look like when I saved it. I'm gonna select it all. Because as you can see, this is all in one line. You know how to edit JSON like this? No, you don't. You don't know how to do that. Stop it. Nobody knows how to do that, except for like savants and stuff. I'm gonna select all of it. I'm gonna copy it. And then I'm gonna head over to JSON formatter. I'm gonna paste it in. See how it looks so like a basic B. You can't do anything with this. Can't do nothing, all right? Then I'm gonna go over here. I'm gonna copy this out. Call, copy, I'm gonna paste it in, I've got my baseline here. All right, now I've got all my colors, I've got my background color. What I need to do is I need to add my background image. Now, I already have my image, but it's not in a base64 converted image. I need to have that base64 converted image for that to work, all right? Because you can't set an image inside of here. You've gotta put in a base64 image, okay? So what I do is I go over to base image editor encoder, and then I drag and drop in. So here's my image again. I drag and drop that in, boom. It's gonna convert it. I'm gonna hit copy image, okay? Then I'm gonna go over and I'm gonna create this section right here, this section. This is gonna be where I'm gonna be putting my image, all right? So from the comma all the way through, this is what I'm gonna be inserting in, and I've gotta replace the base64 image here, all right? Base64 image goes right there, so I've already pasted it, so paste. Oh man, look at that. In order to make sure that this is gonna format, you wanna make sure that you've got this little quotation on the end, and when you hit home, you zoom in, and you see you got the quotation on the front end, okay? So you've got all the stuff that you need right there. You're gonna copy it, you're gonna go back into your image down here, and you're going to find where this out space is and where there's this bracket right here. You're gonna paste that in, making sure that you've got the comma after it and then the values come after it right here, okay? Wow, that got weird on me. All right, so you can see all this stuff is fitting right in here, and it's after the out spaces comma right here, okay? Now, once I have that in place, I'm gonna copy this all, copy, and I'm gonna go back to my JSON formatter. The reason I do this is this is gonna validate to tell me if I got everything right. If it's good, I'm good to go. If I did it wrong, it's gonna give me some error message that I can troubleshoot, okay? This says I'm good to go. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna save this as my KratosBI JSON. I know I'm good to go. So I'm gonna go back into Power BI, go to my themes. And this time, because I've modified it, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna import the one I just created. So I'm gonna hit import. Important that you see import theme. Theme was imported successfully. If you have any errors, if it validated and or if it didn't validate and you just paste it in, you'll get an error. If it validated and you have some formatting issues that don't frickin' work inside of Power BI, you're gonna see an error here. So you're fine if this worked okay, all right? Now, once this is good, I hit close and I test this out in two ways, right? Because this page looks the way it's supposed to look. Now, I go and I hit new page. Fire. Now, any new page I have has that theme image already applied to it. Additionally, because it's a theme that applies to my entire app, if I go back and look at other pages, this theme has been applied to it. Now, Sometimes that's okay. Other times that gets wonky, right? Look at this page. It's a little wonky on here, right? And especially on this one, right? Like, whoa, got to zoom way out. And it looks super wonky down there. That's okay. That's okay. We want this to look good on custom pages like this. All you do is blow that away and you're back to what you had before. No problem. No questions asked. All right. Now, I don't want to see any more garbage looking Power BI reports out there. I want you to take a few freaking minutes, lay out a nice design, create a Power BI theme, create an image that you're going to use by default inside your Power BI reports as a background, so you give your users a consistent look and feel when they engage in your Power BI content. And then I want you to see you create a theme just the way I showed you how to do today. All right. Thank you, guys. If you like this content, you want to see more of it, and I know you do. I know you sons of do. Everyone around the globe wants to watch this stuff, right? You're not some chump. You want to watch the great content? This is where you come for it. You have a great day. Bah!